going on, guys? Aaron from Top Tier Gaming here, and today I'm coming at you with a Tri-Brigade Sprite deck profile. This is a deck that I have seen definitely picking up steam in the OCG, and it's one that I've been playing for a little over a couple weeks, maybe close to a month now. It's a deck I really enjoy. I think it's super cool. It has a bunch of interesting lines of play that get to a really good end board. And yeah, I took it to a tournament that was a pretty decently sized tournament this last weekend. I was able to get top 8, you know, the pricing was okay. I didn't do as well as I wanted, which was unfortunate. I wanted to upload like a first place Tri-Brigade Sprite deck profile, but I did lose to my friend Patty, who got extremely lucky, but it was a good game either way. He played well, so I'm not salty or anything. I just wanted to make a little joke there. But yeah, it was definitely a fun tournament. This deck performed really well, and it did exactly what I wanted it to, but again, it was just a few unfortunate missteps that stopped me from doing as well as I wanted. So I'm going to do the deck profile today, you know, card for card, show you guys the ratios, why I'm playing what I'm playing, and then I will have a separate combo video that should be up the day after this video, because there is so much about this deck, so many different locks you have to keep in mind, so many different lines of play, that it really needs its own video to go over the combo. So when I do have that uploaded, I'll put a link down in the description below where you can check that out. Also, our Discord's down in the description below. And I'm trying to hit 13,000 subscribers. We're really close. I think we're at 12.7K. So if you do enjoy this video and you like it to see here, feel free to like and subscribe. It really helps me out and what I do here on the channel. And yeah, with all that being said, let's hop into this Tri-Brigade Sprite deck profile. Alright, so we're going to go over the 40-card main deck and the 15-card extra deck. And yeah, I'm definitely just going to go over my ratios, why I ran what I ran, and like how they serve their purpose in the deck. Also, shout out to the Matt. This is like a Spy Family, like Tri-Brigade crossover that Amanda LaPalme did. You know, you have Anya as Kit, you have Yor as Farragut, and you have, you know, Lloyd as Shireg. But you guys can't see him, which is unfortunate. But getting on to the deck profile, we are going to start with the Tri-Brigade engine. So we have the 3 Fractal, which is, you know, one of the best starters for the Tri-Brigade engine. And we actually, you know, we have 6 Fractals, so let's go ahead and just show this off right here. So yeah, we're maxing out on our copies of Fractal, which he is interesting. He's one of your 1-card starters, but he's not actually the best 1-card starter. And I plan to do a combo video for this deck, because it does have a lot of different lines based on which starters you draw. And it's going to need its own video. It's going to be a pretty long combo video, so I plan to do it in a separate sort of detailed sort of discussion type video. And yeah, we're maximizing Fractal because we want to see our Tri-Brigade engine, and while he is a 1-card starter, you actually want to see your combo in different ways. That being said, Fractal still gets you quite far by himself, so we are going to max out 6 copies of Fractal. Then we are running 2 Tri-Brigade Kit, which I'm going to actually sort of place her on the mat like this, and 2 Tri-Brigade Karas. So these are like arguably the most important Tri-Brigade monsters in the deck because they are level 2, which means they have natural synergy with your sprite package. Kit in particular feels like the most important Tri-Brigade, which I think, you know, makes a lot of sense because like even lore-wise, Kit interacts with the sprite monster. But yeah, Kit is like really powerful because of her ability to be summoned off Gigantic and then access your Tri-Brigade engine, which is very big. It's one easy way to like just have starter or your sprite package and then get into your Tri-Brigade lineup. So Kit is probably the most important one. And then Karas being one of the most powerful Tri-Brigade monsters simply because it gives you another layer of extending. Like Sprite is known to essentially have its normal summon and its like literally sprite starter as the ways to play through interrupts, right? But Karas gives you like another dimension of a way to play through interrupts and have another way to keep going past what your opponent has for you. And Karas is just phenomenal as an extender and being level 2. It's very important that these are level 2 because once you're Gigantic or starter locked, these are kind of what you're going into. Lastly, we have 2 Nerval, which is sort of an engine requirement. He's probably the worst one because like when you draw him, it doesn't feel great. He's not level 2, he doesn't have any synergy with the sprite monsters, we're not running Almirage, so he doesn't do anything on his own. However, he, again, is mandatory engine requirement for the Tri-Brigade package, otherwise your Fractal does nothing, right? And him being level 1 does come up in certain situations when, like, you only have one banished beast monster, and Shireg needs to, like, search a play. Nerval is searchable by being level 1, so he's important, you need to run him, and I do recommend 2 just because if you draw 1, you still want 1 to send off Fractal, so I do play 2. An important thing to note about these Tri-Brigade monsters is they lock you, like, if you're unfamiliar with the lock they provide, once you use one of these Tri-Brigade monsters' effects, you cannot link summon except with Tri-Beast type monsters like Wing Beast, Beast, and Beast Warrior. That's really important to keep, like, in your the back of your mind going forward, because it does change how, like, this deck combos and how it plays, because that is one of two and arguably three main locks the deck has, so it's important to keep that in mind. Last card in the Tri-Brigade engine is one Tri-Brigade Revolt, and this is sort of the payoff for the engine. Revolt is an insane card. Even, you know, 2023 going into the format, in a Tier 0 format, when I'm playing this deck and I resolve Revolt, it sometimes is just a turn ender. Like, it feels so powerful. It sets up your follow-up, it gives you Shureg, which is a non-target banish, and then, you know, if he goes away, you get another plus. It's truly an insane card, and yeah, it's definitely the payoff for the Tri-Brigade engine. Alright, now for the sprite side of things, and my sprite package changed quite a bit through testing. Originally, it was a very small package, or I guess originally it was a large package, then I slimmed it down to a small package, and then I sort of found myself somewhere in the middle. So, to start off, I am running three Sprite Blue, who I chose to maximize because he gets you, like, the farthest. Technically, Jet and Pure Sprite gets you to, like, the same place, but you don't always want to, like, search starter in this deck to do your sprite plays, because that can hinder you with certain locks, or it most importantly means you're not getting smashers, which is a big part of this deck. So I'd rather start with blue than jet, so we are going to maximize blue. However, I am only running one of each other sprite monster, so we have one jet who arguably you consider to be the most important sprite because he does search smashers for an interrupt. Or like a strong go second card into cards that give Tri-Brigade problems, right? Like, you can search smashers with this guy when you're starting sprite combo and get rid of something like a Zombie World, which can give your Tri-Brigade engine, you know, a tough time. We do run the one red because it's an interrupt, it's very powerful. And then we run the one carrot, which is really good for things like evenly matched, because this deck does struggle with that. You're not making totally awesome in this list, so you don't have an Omni Negate in the sense like that to where evenly matched wouldn't be a problem. So carrot post game one is super huge for that. And yeah, we're just running six sprite monsters, and these do essentially everything you need. Originally, it was one blue, and I was playing four sprite monsters, but blue can help you extend, so I felt like upping him to three was fine. Like, I see some people sort of maximize this package, and play, like, a lot more than this, and I did decide to run two additional copies of blue, but I don't think you want to maximize on these, because it's not exactly the goal of the deck, right? Like, we're not playing pure sprite. However, one you are always going to maximize is the three starter, because this is the best one card combo in your deck. If you start with starter, it's just everything you want and more. Like, starter is so insane for the deck. It's not only just an extender, but, like, being a one card starter to get everything you need in Tri-Brigade Sprite feels a lot nicer than being, like, pure sprite, because in pure sprite you kind of expect it to. Starter is the best sprite card for sure, and that's why we're maximizing it. And then we play the one smashers, because this is almost the payoff for the sprite package as far as, like, an interrupt is concerned. Obviously it gets you your board, but, you know, smashers is a very powerful card, so we do choose to main deck it. Alright, sort of for the engine that I think makes this deck, like, super insane. Like, this engine is played in every sprite list, but it has so much more synergy in this deck, and it's the engine that really brings this archetype together, and that is the three Nimble Beaver and the two Nimble Angler. And this is something you see in all sprite lists, because it's insane with Sprint, and it's just really powerful to get free bodies on board. However, in this deck, it's really crazy because Nimble Beaver is a beast, which means it can be used for your Tri-Brigade effects, which I think is so nice. It means when you sprint, you're not only getting your play, but you're also filling your grave for your Tri-Brigade monsters, and it's just really nice synergy overall. And then Nimble Angler himself has some synergy, because you can, like, Tri-Brigade effect summon Double Dragon Lords going second, pitch Angler, and then get some extension off that, which is pretty cool. So yeah, this package is insane, and then also Nimble Beaver can turn into the likes of Farajit rather than just, like, level 2 sprite stuff. So there's a lot of flexibility with this package in this list, and it's something you definitely want to run. I see some people play one Angler in this version. I'm not quite sure why. I've seen the OCG do it too, and that just doesn't make a lot of sense to me. And maybe it's like other flex spots I'm running in the list make running double Angler even better. But, like, when you start Beaver, you really want to have two Angler in deck. So yeah, I recommend playing two Angler, but I have seen some people play one. And then one Foolish Burial, which is just an amazing card for dumping Nimble Angler as an extender. So this is, like, the fourth way to play past, like, starter, Karas, and your normal summon. But also, if you already had access to Angler and you don't want to use that, you can just dump something like a kit or part of your Tribrigade engine. So it's overall a really flexible, powerful card. One called by the grave. This card's huge because, you know, tier limit is big, so we can stop fusion effects with that. It's just a really powerful one of. For the more like ghost second cards, the flex spots and how I choose to play it, Tribrigade mostly, you know, throughout its lifespan has played a lot of hand traps, but I don't think those are particularly powerful this format, like drawing one or two low impacts. Sometimes just doesn't do enough, so I chose to go a different route. We are still playing hand traps though. We're playing the one DD Crow because it's searchable with your Sure Egg, so. And it's just a winged beast, so you can discard it with Keras. It's engine in that sense, like when your opponent mills it off of like their Kelbeck or their Aegito, you know, it's a beast in grave, so. Yeah, it's sort of why you play this over like one Bestial in this list. Three Infinite Impermanence, which is just probably the best hand trap, but it's also good at just going second, like drawing it as your sixth card. So Imperm is sort of a no-brainer as far as a flex spot is concerned as well. And then we have probably one of my favorite flex spots is, of course, the three Triple Tactics Talent. This is a card I often like to only play two copies of in my list because I feel like drawing multiples can be extremely bad, especially when your opponent doesn't play into it. However, when you're playing Tribrigade, I feel like three is, you know, a no-brainer because even if you draw one or even two dead, you can just put them back with your Tribrigade effects like Ferrugi and Barabrum. So yeah, three tactics. This card is amazing going first or second, and I absolutely love this card. And it's really good in Tribrigade because you have so many putback effects like Barabrum and Ferrugi that sometimes you just need extra cards, so a draw two can really help you get there. And yeah, tactics, phenomenal card. Definitely highly recommend playing three of it. And the last flex spot is actually three Forbidden Droplet. And this is a card that has left the Yu-Gi-Oh! Limelight for quite some time now. But in this deck, it's honestly beyond broken. You have so many cards that synergize with Droplet. Namely, you have things like Nimble Angler. You have Kit and Nerval, which are huge to send off of Nimble Angler because you're just getting value off of like sending these cards off Droplet. But it's not only those. You have things like your Tenkis that stick on the field that you can send for either Double Dragon Lords or a card like Forbidden Droplet. And then you have things like Sprite Starter and Foolish Burial that you can send as well. These are just also high value sends off of Droplet. But not only that, it's pretty well known in Tribrigade that this card's good. And for another reason being the fact that if your opponent is to like Imperm your Tribrigade monster, you can like chain Droplet to dodge the Imperm, right? Like that's a very classic interaction that's been around for quite some time. So I really enjoy Droplet in this deck. It's a really powerful card. It's just a lot of decks can't really play at this format. And I think this is one of the few decks that can, and it really shines. That is it for the main deck. On to the extra deck. I'm going to go in a sort of different order because I'm going to go sort of in the order of the sprite package because you start with the sprite stuff usually first unless you open just Fractal. And it goes a very similar way every time. So we're going to start with the one Sprind, which this is almost always your first play because Sprind gives you access to additional beavers, which makes Gigantic almost free, and with a link under it, which means it's big. Especially going second, you want to start with Sprind. If you're playing around Nibiru specifically, you don't have to start with this. You can go Gigantic initially, but yeah. And then we have the one Gigantic Sprite, which is, you know, a way for your Sprite engine to access your Tribrigade engine because you can special kit. And then also Sprint can dump kit in certain situations as well. So you have multiple different ways through your Sprite engine to get to your Tribrigade engine. And then we have two Elf because Elf is the most important one. It's part of your combos. It's like all of Sprite's grind game. And yeah, if I'm going to suffer to cast here a Unicorn, Elf is something I definitely want two of in my list. So I choose to play two. It also comes up in the grindier games as well. Then for the more Tribrigade stuff, we have the one Lightheart. I choose to play this over Almiraj. I feel like it comes up a lot more, especially in your one card combos, because like Keras or Kit, just making this guy means you can go into a link to like Elf or Sprind for very little cost, right? And like when you're dealing with your opponent's shufflers as well, something like Lightheart is very good because they might be able to hit three, but if you had four in grave, you still have a play. Then we, of course, have the Ferrugite and the Barabrum, very important cards here. You're forced to run these as well. And then Double Dragon Lords, one of the best cards, honestly, in the entire deck of Tribrigade, and it's been that way for a long time. I feel like Double Dragon Lords has always been one of the best cards in the Tribrigade deck to protect either Opelousa or, you know, just be a bounce. It has so many good things it can do. In this deck, it can also send Angler, which I love. You know, it's a very powerful card. So we do play the double Dragon Lords. One IP, this comes up in like, there's a lot of different hands that start with IP and then you make elf with IP. And then you can bring this back on your opponent's turn and go for another link play. So I'll show those hands for sure in the combo video, but I do recommend playing an IP Mascarena. One Pit Knight early, this is part of your main combo because you're going to end with this pointed to elf as sort of another spot negate. It's just something you can very easily link Bearbrum into at the end of your combo, so you want to play the Pit Knight early. Then we run one link three, and I'm choosing Rugal. Like, you could run Hraesthelgr, the Doom Eagle. However, there's times where you activate Revolt and your opponent's shufflebacks could actually mess up your Tri-Brigade count, and you'll need to make Rugal. So I feel like if you're only going to run one of them, I'm choosing to play Rugal, but it could be Doom Eagle. And then two Shireg, this is another Tri-Brigade monster I choose to play two of. I don't make two all the time, sometimes you really only need one, but again, playing around Unicorn, if I'm going to run a second of any other card in my extra deck besides Elf, I think it should be Shireg. There are times where you will make two as well, more so than other cards. So yeah, double Shireg. And then we have one Access Code and one Opelousa. Access, of course, for finishing the game, which this is something Tri-Brigade has always been known for. It's insane at making Access Code. An Opelousa is mostly for like the IP Mascarena on your opponent's turn. It can just be a game-winning play with Elf bringing back IP. But this is Tri-Brigade, so there are times where you can actually make Opelousa turn one. It's rare. You don't often go for that line, but if you get hand-trapped in a really weird way, I guess Opelousa is still there to make for your first turn. All right, and that's going to do it for the Tri-Brigade Sprite deck list. I hope you guys enjoyed. I am going to be making a combo video for this deck because it has a bunch of different lines. You have like an end board that you desire, but how you get there is different. So I really want to do a combo video for it. And yeah, I hope you guys stay tuned for that. If you did enjoy this deck profile, give a like and subscribe. This has been Aaron from Top Tier Gaming. Bye, YouTube.